いじめだけはきちんと取りたいんや。リュウジと一緒に逮捕してください。
お見事や。合田会長、桐生さん。ここまでは見事に私の筋書き通りに動いてくれました。まさか、その声は寺田。Surprise!
He's not dead!
どういうことや?
これはすべて私が描いた絵図なんですよ。 26年間考えに考え抜いたね。
それじゃあなたが?
そう。
And he's also a secret Korean.
26年前の事件、最後の生き残りですよ。
The last survivor of the Jingon massacre from 26 years ago, which also recontextualizes him killing Shimano back in Kiwami or the first game. It seemed like a self-defense thing at first, but now that we know that he's a secret Korean, it was revenge.
あなたが動けば、大海も動く。そして関東と関西は一触即発の状態になる。そういう筋書きです。じゃあお前は、リュウジを焚きつけるために、杯の話を持ち出したんだな。ええ。
リュウジは東条会と大海の杯など絶対に認めるわけがない。予想通りクーデターを起こして関東に牙を向けた。そしてあなたに倒される。まあ、これも計算のうちでしたがね。
He played us all like damn fiddles.
標的だったっていうのか?
At this point, this guy's just a fucking conductor.
リュウジは我々の掟に背いた。だからです。 リュウジは人軍を派として行動することを拒み続けた。彼にとっては26年前の恨みなどどうでもよかった。頭にあるのは自分が頂点に立つことだけ。それならそれを利用して最後は掟に従い死んでもらおうと思ったんですよ。寺田、桐生さん、 あとはあなたを片付けて、東条会を潰せば全ては終わる。長かった。 やっとだ。寺田幸男として生きた26年間、あと少しでそれも終わる。あなたたちを倒し、あの爆弾にスイッチを入れれば全てが終わるんだ。爆弾。気がつかなかったんですか。あなたたちの目の前にあるじゃないですか。
By the way, there was one more bomb left. It's right here.
どうして？爆弾はすべて解除したはずだ。倉橋の分ですよ。あなたの父親河原二郎が殺した倉橋のね。あなたたちは私の同志、いや親友を奪い去った。だからその復讐をする私が用意したんですよ。
このスイッチを押せば、カムロ町が火の海になります。本気なの？安心してください。この爆弾が爆発する頃、あなたたちはすでにこの世にはいないんですから。寺田。何ですか？最後に教える。お前はあの時、風間のおやっさんの墓前で、 嘘をついたのか。何が言いたいんですか。26年前、お前を助けたのは風間のおやっさんなんじゃないのか。
なんでそれを。
26年前のあの日、俺はお前を見ていた。
어떡하지영민아
씨발이래서는오래못버텨
이놈아우리도가자인욱의원수를갚아야지
그래뒤에서치면이길수있을거야
어
生きろ。お前らは若い。命を無駄にするな。生きろ。
そうだったんですか。あなたがあの時の。確かに私と四人は風間さんによって命を救われた。
寺田。
その後私は復讐をするため風間さんを狙い続けた。来る日も来る日も。だが風間さんはそんな私を逆に世話し近江へと導いてくれた。
そうか、それでか。お前が近江に入った後、堂島の風間という男がお前のことを頼みにやってきた。私に手をついて何度もお前のことを。
寺田、お前風間のおやっさんにそこまでしてもらって人間としての恩はねえのか。
桐生さん、まだわから
ない。 Probably does say no and then cackles.
私は人言派の構成員です。人言派の掟は全てに優先する。たとえ親だろうがやるときはやる。それが私たちの宿命です。
血の通った人間の言葉じゃねえな。
ええ、私たちは人間であることを捨てた集団だ。そうでなければ26年間も恨みを抱えてこのような復讐を計画することなどできません。とにかくあなたを倒さなければ終わらない。
How do I know the I feel like all the bosses in this game suck.
In what way?
I don't like any of their motivations.
Yeah! Also, that submachine gun flurry there and Kiryu just blocking it is why you want the sacred tree armor, because otherwise you are going to eat so much shit. I'm not super on board with Kim's motivations either. I really question what the Jingon even, what is their purpose as an organization? Because all I really get out of their everything in this game is that they just exist for revenge.
Yeah.
Anyway, halfway through the fight, you get this QT where Terada shoots a steel beam down at you, and I always fucking miss that one because I never see it coming. Like, you get like half a second to react.
Yeah, that was pretty crazy. Also, him just like shooting all those bullets at you is pretty crazy.
Seriously, sacred war armor. Make absolutely fucking sure you have that going in. I was very sad on PS2 when the Black Arms dealer wasn't downstairs. Like, if he shoots you from the back, you're still gonna, you know, take damage. But, you know.
Yeah.
Most of the time, you should be facing him anyway. I'm impressed with his aim, though, if he can just, shoot completely around his subordinate there.
I mean, you're not a boss for nothing,
really. True, true. Alright, here's the next QTE. And with that, we've got a field heat action. Those two QTEs also existed on PS2, incidentally. And I always miss the steel beam one on PS2 as well. The third or fourth time they've used this one, I think, in Kiwami 2.
Kiryu, mada ya.
Mo, omae to no shoubu wa owatte iru.
I've got a bucket of whiteout for your script.
Osokatta yanai ka.
Surprise!
Takashima!
He's still involved.
あなたには感謝して。私にとって邪魔な人間を予定通り次々と葬ってくれましたからね。ご苦労だったな。あとは私に任せろ。全てお前が裏で仕組んだんか。
This guy's like so good.
Seriously? Hasn't even wasted a shot. Terada was the conductor? I guess he's the composer.
Takashima.
And is surprisingly not a secret
Korean.
So,
その目的は果たせた。だからもう、お前は用済みだ。
寺田自分が利用されているとも知らず、バカな男だ。
やはり、お前という男は…高島、お前…うわ高島、お前、近江をどないするつもりや？
ご安心ください。私があなたの後を引き継ぎます。
そんなことは許さん。
メイドの土産に教えましょう。私は近江連合六代目となり、東条会を傘下に収める。極道社会の全国制覇です。さらに神言派も抑え海外へ進出する。それが私が書いた最後の絵図です。
お前どう
ゴーダさんどいつもこいつもバカばっかりだ。どうしてこう人を信用するのか信じられん。
わしは心の底からお前のことなんか信じちゃいない。
なんだ、まだ生きてたのか、この死に損ないが。
お前の思った通りにはならん。今にわかる。
全くうるさい連中だ。
キリュウさん。
I want you die.
あんたしかいない。この男を倒してくれ。
Oh yeah, somehow I looked away from you, even though I just shot you.
さ、最後に俺を。
Oh, why though?
Yeah, I don't know.
Nani?
I mean, it's nice in theory, but...
You haven't given us a whole lot of reason to trust you. You've even activated the bomb for some reason.
前技撃ちますよ。
構わないわ、撃って。
カオル、
カズマ、撃つのよ。いいから撃って。
キリュウ、カズマ、お前には撃てない。人を見殺しにできない。それがお前の
弱さ。 I mean, I don't really think it's sacrifices. My guy Kiryu, you suck
バカな男だ。
Okay, so we shot Kiryu twice.
お前もあの男のよう。
Head of the Omi twice. We shot Terada like three times.
And he's getting shot up, I don't know how many times.
And you know, nobody ever seems to run out of ammo. That's great.
Yeah, don't piss off Ryuji.
お前みたいなバカに裏をかかれるとは。
男はのバカなくらいでちょうどいい。我のような計算高い男は所詮天下など取れんのや。
All right, round two.
Yup, there's... I'm not sure there's a whole lot of reason to fight, but you know what? They're both bleeding out. They're... The bomb's about to go off. What better way to finish this off than one last round?
Of course.
その通りだ.
ちょっと、何してるの? 爆弾のスイッチが入ってるのよ! あと5分で爆発するわ!
ねえ、頭がぼーっとしてきよって。
Could call an ambulance. Whatever. Thrill of the fight, am I right?
All they have left is their pride.
Damn it,
only one of them can walk out with it.
Damn it, not again!
そして生きろ. 俺にはまだやることがある.
こんな男初めて. さすがわしの妹が惚れた男や. こいつの言う通りや. 早う逃げ.
な、何言ってるのよ! 私はもうこれ以上家族が死ぬのは嫌だ! 好きな人が死ぬのも嫌なんや!
分かってる。
だったら今すぐ!
うっさいわボケ! なあ、わしらもうボロボロや。
No, you could just ignore him and call an ambulance anyways? Maybe?
時間がないや。
でも…
It'll probably take too long for the ambulance to get here.
I mean, every second you delay confirms that, yes.
Can
you help her, please? How dumb are you? and that's when out of sight she immediately pushed the emergency stop button and went back
up.
And now it's time for the final boss fight. It's a real hand-to-hand brawl with Ryuji. Of everything in Yakuza 2, I think this fight might be the most iconic thing from the game.
I can see where any and all inspiration for the melee like fights in every Metal Gear Solid game comes from.
I have to say,
Metal Gear Solid, like, probably does a better take at this.
Yeah, the Metal Gear probably does a better lead up, but yeah, the actual fight though, it's real good.
I'm revisiting in my brain Metal Gear Solid 4, and it's like, you know what? That game had it better.
Okay, you know what? That's not fair. The Metal Gear Solid 4 is like best in class. This kind of setup.
Yeah, but you know, these guys should be the innovators.
Look, MGS2 came out 2 years after Yakuza 2.
Again, you're trying to excuse this game.
Well, in any case, that QT with Ryuji straddling Kiryu is actually, that's one of Ryuji's heat actions you can pull on you. He doesn't have too many, but, Yeah, I did a run later on where I just did not see that one at all. Like, I thought it was a scripted thing, but no, that's just him, knocking you down. So coming up is going to be the final QTE. I think you're safe to miss it on this version, but on PS2, you better not miss this QTE because it's game over if you do. That cross counter is also very, very cool.
Yes.
Aru, we sent you down for a reason.
Like I said, all you had to do is just have it go the other way. Plain and simple.
Ogun to onnaji niyui. Ogun no koto wo omoetoru nka? Sou ka. Kawaisou ni na. どんな人やった?お前に、よう似とるわ。初めてお前に会った時、おかんを思い出したからの。
One who wouldn't even call emergency services to save my life. If only I'd known, I would have done so much more to be with you, unlike now, where I don't want to be with you. By the way, I'm dying. That's okay, you're losing a lot of that right now.
Yeah, I guess, because Ryuji is full Jingon child, like, he figures that the gang is going to murder him at some point, so he'd rather go out, like this.
Sooner rather than later, yes, like a moron.
More importantly, going out, after one last duel.
Like the idea that somehow the Jingon always survives. And even though now we've killed even more of like, all their people, and everybody who could have had a grudge against anybody like 30 years ago is now dead. Like at this point, unless the Jingwang like purposefully will always go after somebody for the sole purpose of like revenge, and this would never end.
Yeah, that's kind of the sense I get with the Jingon. Like, that's all they're doing, just revenge.
Yeah. Like, at a certain point, I'm sure they would have cut their losses.
No, never. They will never cut their losses.
Like, this is a business expense that we are always losing. We're always in the red, goddammit.
Like, they take sunk cost fallacy to the extreme. Just drag him to the elevator. It's okay, yeah. You can do it.
If only I called emergency services. Is that your brother's blood? Please don't touch me. It could have a hepatite.
あなたを置いて逃げられないわ。俺のことは放っておけ。そんなことできない。早く。早く。逃げるんだ。うるさい。私はあなたと一緒にいるの。
like how the background music's all like, burn it down.
I forget what this song is called, but they really wanted to make sure people who played this game knew it.
キリュウ。あと1分ないのか。はるかちゃんのこと裏切っちゃったね。そうだな。でもきっとはるかなら。
No, I don't think she will.
Wait for it to explode, like when it quote unquote explodes and it just like sends out confetti.
I think that's all the blood, Sayama. So that's Yakuza Kiwami 2 with a little bit of Yakuza 2 mixed in. I still think Yakuza 2 as a whole is pretty great. I think with the fact that a bunch of really good ones have come out in the past couple years, I'd say it's like mid tier now, but. I don't know. For me,
like, I enjoyed the game. I mean, you take away your own opinions of the combat as you see it. But, like, there's a lot of great parts in it. I like some of the characters, but I don't know. The last, like, two videos where, like, everything comes to an end, and it's like, I just don't appreciate any of, like, the story.
Yeah, the overarching plot is, I don't think, one of this game's strong suits. Like, this game has a lot of really great moments, but a lot of the set dressing doesn't really do it for me.
Yeah.
Like, I love the rivalry between Kiryu and Ryuji and how that gets settled, but I am definitely not a fan of the Jengon.
Yeah. I mean, as like a full, like, that's your main opponent, I can see why I probably wouldn't have him. But as just like a, you know, side character in this entire thing, it's fine.
Yeah, like, if the game had a little more focus on the actual, like, rivalry between Ryuji and Kiryu, I think, and a, you know, less focus on what on the Jengon trying to blow the shit out of the two towns or whatever, I think the narrative would have been a little better for it.
Yeah, I can see that.
I don't know. Definitely a step up from Yakuza 1's narrative, though, I'd say. There's really a whole lot of nothing happening in that one every time I think about it.
I mean, I would give the first game a pass just because it's the first game, right?
Yeah, like, no, absolutely.
As long as the concept is fine, like, for me, that's generally enough. I guess, like, you could probably say they didn't have, like, they didn't hit their stride with the second game. Like, okay, sure. But, yeah. I mean, I think it doesn't help that these last two episodes are obviously like very fresh. So we're obviously I'm going to nitpick these rather than any other problems that may have happened earlier. But, yeah. Just, like, everybody turning out to be, like, when I make the joke, like, everybody happens to be, like, the uncle or brother or something, and everybody's in the mafia, and it's like, yeah, actually, that's true. Everybody was.
Yeah.
It's like, hold on, no, wait, that's not supposed to be the case. Damn it.
Yeah. Yeah, and then, like, I think half of the new cast, at least, was, like, a secret Korean in some way.
Secret Korean is the next party game that people will rave about.
It's Among Us, but you have to find out who... Actually, I'm not going to finish that sentence.
I mean, I thought it was just going to be, like, Werewolf or the other one.
Or Mafia?
Well, I was going to say, like, Secret Hitler, but I'd rather not bring that guy's name up if we don't have
to. But yeah, I feel like the bit of story we've seen in the last two episodes where like everything just kind of starts coming to a head at like mock speed. I haven't finished 3 through 5 for myself, but I feel like that happens a lot. I've heard that it's really bad with those games. Like, frankly speaking, I feel like it took until 0 for them to put out a game that's like universally acclaimed across the board. Which, I mean, nothing wrong with that, but I'm just kind of amazed that it took them to 0 to do it, you know?
So I guess if I had to take something out from that, I'd probably say that it's likely due to Yakuza not really hitting it with American audiences for a while.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably part of it too. Like, a lot of the narratives can be kind of a mess from what I understand. And I don't think it's a coincidence that, like, the first one that really made it super big was the one that, how do I put it? One of the neat, you know, the more neater and tightly wrapped narratives.
Right.
You know, among other things, too. Like, Zero is just a fantastic package all around.
Right.
All in all, though, you know what? Kiwami 2, still one of the better titles in the series. Solid gameplay, great set pieces, some of the really high highs.
I like the idea of the, there was something about this game's treatment of, like, leveling up your character and stuff that I think I appreciated more than some of the other games.
Yeah, you know what, I do like that too, just like how you, get 5 different experience points types, and you can just spend them all individually on different skill types.
Mm-hmm. And just like how the breakdowns for each type work.
Yeah, it's more or less the same system that was in Yakuza 6. Mm. I think the only real quirk I'd say about that is the fact that you can very easily break the experience curve because. Or by just eating out a stored menu, and then drowning in Pepto-Bismol to empty your stomach.
Right.
Like I have a lot of footage of just me doing exactly that. Just because I really wanted like Tiger Drop or something.
Yeah, but I mean, I guess you could say like it could finesse that a little bit. But at the very least, like, it's an interesting system because you're rewarded in specific ways based on the approach, like based on your gameplay that you want to perform, and I mean, looking at it from outside in, it definitely looks like the subsequent actions that you would be buying with the specific rewards you would get from doing specific things kind of like all play into each other.
Right, right.
It's like it's just a good feedback loop, basically.
ありがとうね。私、ずっと忘れないよ。寺田のおじさん、本当にありがとう。
あの爆弾が偽物だったとは、寺田が一番の役者だったな。
ああ、奴が言っていた通り、高島のことは、
I don't understand why the bomb was a fake.
そうだな。
Well, you see,
最初から爆弾の信管は抜かれていたわけだしな。
Of course, the fuse wasn't
in. 花から爆発させる気はなかったってことだ。
Why make a big show of it, fans?
爆弾が起動した時はどうなるかと思ったぜ。
ああ。だがあの時、寺田の判断がなければ。
Oh, I guess that's why. Somehow.
あの爆弾が爆発しないことが分かっていたのか？
いや、分からなかった。だが奴は最後に信じてくれと言った。
お前に何を信じて欲しかったんだろうな。
多分、風間のおやっさんへの気持ちだったんだと思う。今思えばな。
なるほどな。その言葉に嘘はなかったってわけだ。
ああ。
Kiryu lived happily ever.
The end.
Man, I'm so confused. Normally when I see a scene at a graveyard, I'm just expecting a guy helping another guy in a wheelchair, and someone's got a gun and is like threatening to kill themselves.